A reading from the notebooks by Maria Valtorta, 1943, November the 6th. Footnote. In pencil, the writer adds a reference to chapter 15, still alluding to the Book of Wisdom. Jesus says, I know that you are surrounded by snares and weak. I know and take this into account when judging you. I would no longer be just if I did not take into account your weakness and the works of the evil one. What makes me become severe is that you often do not fall out of weakness or a demoniacal snare. You fall knowingly. You deliberately throw yourselves into the abyss, saying, And what do I care about God? It is then that I call you Judas. You sell me with my precious blood. You hand me over to Satan by giving him your souls, which are mine, for I bought them back by my death. You betray me by calling yourselves Christians, while performing works as anti-Christians. Judas also consumed the Eucharist, and with me in his breast went to take the money of barter, and with his hands contaminated by that money, he embraced me to point me out to the enemy. Judas causes you disgust, but in what way do you act differently? You that seek to exploit your position as Christians for your own purposes and do not serve the interests of Christ. You serve them so little that you leave him to chase after the seducer. How much mercy I will have for those who fall with a will opposed to falling, and who repent of their falling. 1, 2, 10, or 100 non-malicious falls do not mortally wound love. They are mutual scratches, which your tears heal and my love restores to health. You say to me, Mercy, Lord, and I say to you, Come, poor child, to the Father. You are always mine until love is dead in you, and it is for the wounded children that I gave my blood. Be just, then, and merciful to yourselves, as I am. Strive to know me and love me so as not to deprive your souls of their right to eternal joy. Get back onto the way of life. My commandments are that way. Seek to bear them in mind during your day, for if weakness then drags you into slight errors, I assure you that you should not be demoralized over it. Tomorrow you will do better than today, and the day after tomorrow, better than tomorrow. A plant grows slowly. Every day a new little root. Every day a new leaf. But how beautiful it is when it has grown. Perfection is like this, children. It is conquered by degrees. But what do you think, that I will give a lesser reward to those who did not reach the maximum immediately? No, on the contrary. Between those who were holy by my grace and those who wanted to be holy against their nature, I will gaze with eyes twice as loving at this hero of love. The reward in eternity is one alone, the vision of God. But the initial embrace of union between the combatants who are victorious over the flesh, the world, and the devil, in whom throughout life the latter have agitated their serpentine essence, cut off 1,000 times and rising again 1,000 times, shall be powerful with a special ecstasy. I tell you so. Believe me, the truth. How urgent is the need for that memory in you now? You die from not remembering to be Christians. Turn to the Christ. Wisdom says, And those who turned to that sign were not healed by what they saw, but by you, the Savior of all. That's it, O children. You are not healed of your individual and public infirmities because you are unable to see me. Practices do not count. Reprisals create vaster evil. Acts of vengeance kill those committing them before those enduring them. Footnote. At the foot of the page, the writer adds, Is this also referring to the bombing of the Vatican tonight? The shelters fall without sheltering you, but if you came to me, you would be saved, in regard to the life of this earth and that of the hereafter. I repeat, footnote, mentioned in the text of October 23rd, my wish, let many acts of adoration be offered to the cross, which is the throne of power of Jesus, your Savior. As the serpent raised up on the cross had the power to heal the Jews, so I, the one who is immortal, raised up on the cross, will have the power to set to flight what frightens and torments you. For I am the Lord of life and death, and can place life where death is already imminent, and overcome by death by calling back to life. No one except me can do this. Satan can give you all powers, but not that of calling back vital movement. On the contrary, he teaches you to shatter lives with hatred for the giver of life, who, to nourish you not only for bodily life, for which he has grain germinate and form ears, but for spiritual life, gives you the bread which the angels adore, because it is the flesh of the Son of God. He gives it to you, not asking for anything in exchange except love and faith, and indeed, like a holy beggar, asks you to receive him into yourselves, for he makes being with you his joy. In you that bread is transformed into life and grace. It is transformed into salvation, light, joy, and wisdom. You become all when you are all with the Son of God. The word of the Father speaks softly when he remains like a heart in your breast. And it is my word that conserves for eternal life those who do not forswear their supernatural filiation. Blessed are those who not only love you, O thought of the Father whom love makes the word, in the hours of joy, but who even before there is joy, even under hurricane clouds, bless you. Light that experienced no pause in shining. Blessed are those who are able to praise you with tears in their eyes and trust in their hearts and are certain of your mercy. In truth, I tell you that whoever is able to hope in God with the most beautiful act of faith while the darkness is hanging overhead, bringing despair, shall know the eternal sun. There are few of these true believers, too few. In this night of impotence which has come out of hell, the infirm spirits fall like leaves, disintegrated by water and torn away by the wind. Their weight drags them along. And as an increase of the flesh, they have Satan, who keeps them blinded and tightly grasped to prevent them from making an effort at elevation which would suffice to save them. Fear and discouragement dull them, vice paralyzes them, and despair burns them. They are ruins trembling over vain shadows and do not know that they ought to tremble over themselves as slayers of their immortality. The churches are emptied, the altars lack worshippers. The mystical bread is not sought after. The three virtues are languishing or dead, and the cardinal virtues as well. There is rage and a chaotic effort to seek salvation, and disdain and derision for the children of the light, more than disdain, a desire to oppress them, to put out that light, which is hateful to them. But the more they deride and crush you, O dear children who are my light brought to men, the more this world will plunge into darkness. The crime, footnote, at the foot of the page the writer poses a question. Perhaps another allusion to the bombing of the city of the Sons of Light. The crime and the crimes shall form a wall and barrier for the light, and under that onerous shelter humanity shall perish in a desperate jail. Go ahead and reject the signs I send you from heaven, and laugh at the celestial warnings. Go ahead and believe everything is licit for you. When you least expect, I will have you experience a sign before which you shall plummet in terror. And the wrath you now unleash against the defenseless, footnote, at the foot of the page the writer adds, and here, will be flung back upon you. I am that sign. At my appearance, not on earth, the time has not yet come, but spiritually, to the children of wrath and to the father of extermination, your arms and his shall fall like dust when the wind dies down. And if prayers had risen from the earth instead of curses, that appearance of mine would already have occurred, and you would now be liberated from your terrors. Unfortunates who tremble and are unable to come to the one who loves you. It is I who overcome. It is I who know. And it is a great affliction for me to see you running here and there like frightened sheep, following the most foolish advice, obeying those who are wicked in addition to being foolish. I would like to die a second time just to open the eyes of your souls and make you that holy, great, and glorious people that God had proposed to make when he created the first parent. I would like to create you a second time, just to be able not to see you far removed from my thought. But what is, is. I am speaking to all. I will be heard by few, comprehended by fewer still. Wisdom is no longer loved, and is no longer comprehended. But to his faithful ones, wisdom shall always give strength and light on earth, salvation and joy beyond the earth. He shall give himself. And the man who has served him and merited shall be among the 144,000 about whom John speaks, and the holy Jerusalem shall be his, in which there is the throne of the wisdom, who immolated himself to bring himself to men of good will.